Hey guys, welcome to the channel of Tabletop Generals. I am Andreas, and what you see in front of you is a mysterious box that has seen better days, but oh well. I'm going to do an unboxing today from Fantasy Welt. More specifically, these are the Polish vehicles from Gromlech Historical. Yeah, so let's go right in. I'm very excited. This is my first in-person look to on some Polish vehicles from Gromlech Historical. So that's pretty great. Let's see. I've seen some pictures on the internet, and it looked like some really high-quality products. So I think what we are going to see here, what we are going to find in this box, is going to be something that I will like. Okay, let's see. So that's the 70p. Okay, this is already looking really good, but we will take a closer look at this in a moment. This is a TKS tankhead, TK3. Okay. This is another one. I think both have two dimensions. And then we have a bunch of cardboard. So, yeah. This really is the best thing in this box, clearly. Really excited. Let's take a closer look. No, just kidding. Let's get right into the miniatures. So, here we are. Let's see. Let's start with this one. So, this is the number 2015, and from the looks of it, it has depending on what this is supposed to be, then this is the 20mm cannon. Oh yeah, right. This is the machine gun. This is the cannon. So these two don't have both weapon options. So just one each. So let's take a closer look at the product. This is looking really, really good. Yeah, I'm not really seeing any flashes or bubbles. Not a lot of stuff from the molding process. So that's really good. It's going to make it a lot easier. So here we have these. I don't like when they put these, when they mold it in such a way that you have to cut something off of the tracks. So I hope that this isn't going to be a huge problem, but it doesn't look like it's going to be. But it's just a minor nitpick, something that I just don't like. Yeah, the cannon's looking pretty good too. It's a bit crooked, but you know, it's metal, so yeah. Ah, okay, I see. So this is this belongs here. Okay, so that's another piece. Yeah, so looks like a, well, it's not the simplest of assemblies, but it's pretty simple, and the quality is really good. I'm really liking what I'm seeing here. Okay, I wasn't sure at first, but it seems that the TK3 and TKS are two different tankheads, but they are basically the same in many ways. But there are 10 different variations of these tankheads, and about 600 of them were used. But the one with the 20mm cannon, there were only 24 of those, so these were pretty rare. Or nonetheless, I'm going to field one, because this is just a really great asset. especially if you're facing motorized or mechanized even Germans. So let's move on to the one with the machine gun. 280 of these were built, of these TK3, and this is supposed to be a TK3. And of the TKS there were 260. But they're basically the same rules wise, and yeah, so that's a minor difference. Again, looking really good. Just these holes here on the side, so that's going to make it easier to fit the tracks in, which is going to be important. I've seen quite a few models where this is where the tracks fit in a crooked way, so it looks kind of bad. So what I haven't mentioned yet is the amount of detail. There are a lot of details depicted here, so all these little the shovel, for example, so here's another one of these. I think this is the exhaust pipe, and the motor is somewhere in here. I'm not entirely sure, but I think that's how it is. So here we have the tracks again. There isn't a lot I have to cut away here, so that's pretty good. But again, on the tracks here, the molding connects to the tracks, so that's, yeah, I would prefer if they did it like this to these sides, but maybe there's something that I don't have sufficient understanding of to make these judgments, because I'm not doing this myself, obviously. So yeah, but nonetheless, it's just a thought. Here's the machine gun. Nothing special there, and I'm not sure what this is. I will have to find it out. I think that also fits somewhere here. Oh, I will see when I'm assembling them, which I'm not going to do in this video. Okay, so let's get to the really big one. It's 70p, which is going to be a great asset. Which is going to be basically my tank. So, real tank. So, let's see. Yeah, I think there was a little bit more detail here, but I think that might just be because of the design of the tank. So it's more spread out, basically. But I'm really not seeing any remains from the molding, which is fantastic. And there don't seem to be any bubbles. And it's also not really irregular or anything, so this is really good. I really like this. Let's take a look at the turret. I'm not sure what this is, but I think this will not be visible when it's painted. It's just something I was wondering. Interesting. So let's see if it, yeah, it fits really well, but it's not really it doesn't go in deep, so not sure how stable it's going to be. I'll have to see how that works out when it's assembled. Can always make changes here before I start painting them. And regarding the painting, there's a really gorgeous color scheme for them in the Flames of War book. And I'm going to make it like this, but because I think it It looks really, really good, and it's just a cool color scheme, and it's going to look great on a table. So I'm going to try my best at getting that across. Yeah, so this is the paint scheme, the color scheme. As you can see, it looks great, and it's pretty unique. There are other factions that use something like this, but usually you just see the plain green of the Russians, or the plain gray or dark yellowish of the Germans, or the other weird color that the Americans use. But here you have reflective green, dark sand, and flat brown all combined to make this amazing look. So what I mean is, they're not entirely unique. These are the French vehicles, and they also have a similar scheme, but in general it's not entirely unique, but it's relatively rare, especially to see on the table, because usually people make their tanks all gray or something. So these elaborate color schemes, I think it's going to be a challenge, but you know, you grow from challenges, so I'm hoping I will manage to get this right, and if I do, it will look awesome. By the way, here's roughly the, oh, facial recognition. Anyways, this is roughly the color scheme I'm going with for the infantry. Anyways, it's an unboxing, not a workbench. So let's go back to the tanks. We still have the tracks to look at. And okay, I am not entirely sure what. Actually, I think. Okay, I will have to figure this out. What is supposed to be here and what isn't. But it looks like everything is all right here. So that's amazing. And that despite the fact that these are so detailed and there's thin pieces in here and all. So that's pretty great. And then finally we have a few smaller pieces here. So this is an exhaust pipe. I will have to see where exactly I'm going to put this, but that's for that, you will see that in a workbench. Not far from here, because we have to really get everything ready in the next few weeks. Anyways, this is the gun barrel. Looks also pretty nice, so yeah. I have to say I'm pretty impressed. I knew they were probably pretty good. I knew that they weren't terrible based on the pictures, but I'm actually impressed. They outdid my expectations even. So I'm pretty amazed, and I'm absolutely glad that I bought these, because these models, they look great. So it's perfect. And they also have the Jeep, not the Jeep, the truck, the Fiat 621, I think. So I don't think that's available anywhere else, except for maybe via 3D printing. Yeah, I think there are some businesses and people who print these, but the fact that I can get this from Komlech Historical is great, because this is something that I really need for my 10th motorized, for my unit. So that's pretty great. They're really filling some gaps there. So yeah, overall, very, very positive impression, and I think I will buy more from them. In fact, I have a truck ordered, and we will see what else I'm going to buy from them. And then maybe you will see it in another unboxing or workbench video. So yeah, thanks for tuning in. Remember to have fun with wargaming and with your hobby. And don't start 5 projects at once, because it's not going to be great. And yeah, thanks for tuning in, and see you later. Bye!